Hi everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video I'm going to show you a quick and easy way to make a little paper Christmas stocking that you can actually hang on the mantle if you wanted to or give as a gift. It has accordion pocket in between so that you can add in some treats and small gifts. So I'm going to show you how to make this. I'm using the Prima Christmas in the Country paper collections. This is what I had, some of the paper I had left from my design team project for Country Craft Creations. I used an A4 paper pad and some snowflakes, die cuts from a stash, some ribbon that I had, some braid trim. I did use the paper from the collection and the flowers that are available to go with this collection that you can order from Country Craft Creations. I added in some of these red glitter stems from my stash, but everything else. To make a paper Christmas stocking, you're going to need two sheets of the 12 by 12 cardstock. I'm using an artisan burgundy from Country Craft Creations, and you're going to need two pieces of Christmas paper. I'm using the A4 size, Prima's Christmas in the Country, also from Country Craft Creations, and you'll need a stocking template. I will have the link to a template on my drive so that you can click on it and print it up to create one of these. So this is what we're going to start off with, and I'm going to be using the Art Glitter Glue from Country Craft Creations as well. So let's get started. I'm going to make the accordion inside for the stocking so that you can put little goodies and candies and things inside the paper stocking. This is what we're going to be making first. This is the inside. It's an accordion with a 1-inch size so that it makes it a little bit bigger so you can even get your hand in there to attach to between the two layers of your paper stocking. So we're going to make this. You need one piece of the cardstock. We're going to cut one piece that is 7 inches. By 9.5. And then you'll need another piece that is going to be the finished size piece that is 6 inch by 3 3/8. And that's just under an eighth under the 3.5 inch size. So I'm going to make it 3 3/8 there like that. Now we need to get our scoreboard. So take your 7 by 9.5 piece, put the 9.5 inch at the top, and we're going to score at 1 inch, 2, and 3. Completely turn it around to the other side, still have 9.5 inch at the top, score at 1, 2, and 3. So it will look like this. You'll have about a 3.5 inch space right here in the middle. Now turn it to the 7-inch side, and we're going to make 1 1-inch score. Okay, so let me grab my mat. Next, we're going to cut out where you've here on the bottom where you have your 1 inch. You have 3 squares. We're going to cut out all 3 of these. So I'm going to make an angle cut here to the corner and then cut all 3 of these little 1-inch squares out. So this is what you cut out here. And we're going to do the same over here. An angle cut. This is making it like a tab. And then cut out all 3 of the 1-inch squares. We don't need those anymore. Like that. Now then, I'm going to fold and burnish this back towards the front, turn it over, score backwards, turn it back, and score again. So that you have this accordion shape here. So we're going to score in on itself. scallops aside, score back away, and then score back in. So it should be the same on both sides. So you have the V going in. Okay, so there we have that. And then we're going to open this up, and I'm going to score this, get a good score on this bottom tab. Lift it up. We're going to fold these in. Now I'm going to put glue. Flatten this down. Put glue here on the edge, just where this tab is. Put a good amount of glue. Do it on both sides. So you flatten this down on each side. Put your glue in just where this is going to hit this side piece. Flatten it down. Bring this in. This in and burnish it down in place. So you should have it looking like that. It's attached to the back. Now take your other piece that you cut out, your 3 by 3/8 by 6, and check it to see if you need to trim it down any. I think it's going to be okay. You want to make sure it's flush up here at the top. So I'm putting my glue just on this 1-inch section here on the back sides, on the bottom, and on both sides. Now line it up here at the top to make sure that it's even. This is where we want to make sure it's going to be even. And it's not going to go completely side to side. You have a little bit of gap on each edge. And then we want to bring it flush to the bottom if possible. If it sticks out a little bit over the bottom down here, that's okay. We want to make sure it is flush here at the top. If not, then you can trim a little bit of the excess off. I'm just going to burnish and make sure it is stuck down good. So this is the accordion pocket for our Christmas stocking. So let's set that aside, let it dry good. Now we're going to take this other piece cardstock and our template. Now you can either draw or cut. So I'm going to take a fine tip marker and I'm going to line this up on the side so I don't have to cut all of it. Right there. I'm going to across just to get the stocking shape. Okay, and then we're going to do it the other side. I'm going to lay this one all the way up the top so I don't have to cut here and here. So this way I can just draw here. Oops. Can't even draw. Curve straight. Okay, so let's cut those out. Use my bigger scissors on part of this. And move your paper more, especially on the curves, more so than you move the scissors. Cut it along the line. Best you can. So now I'm going to match these up, and usually they are not going to be the same because that's just the way it goes. I'm going to make sure the tops are the same, the side, and then I'm going to flip it over and I'm going to see where I might need to match them up. One toe, I knew I had gone in too much on one. So that's the base of our stocking. And hopefully this will fit right in there like that. Okay, I'm going to cut my pattern paper next. Move this out of the way. Now then, I want to use this side. So I'm going to mark on the back side. So I need one cut this direction. So that's the front side. I'll do this one first. And I'm going to try to line it up with the pad, with the design here, to try to make sure it's kind of straight, at least at the top. And depending on where you want it, what image you want, you can do it this way. I'm going to draw it here. So this one's going to be, should be the front, so I'm going to go ahead. And I'm going to try to cut just to the inside of the line to make this just a little bit smaller than the cardstock ones that I cut out. Okay, so that should fit there. I may have to trim some places just a little bit. We'll see. And now we need the other one. Cut this off right here and save that paper for another project. So the back side, make sure I have the top here. Now, it's going to have to go the opposite way, so I'm thinking. Got to do some thinking. Cut this out. So that should be correct. So I'm going to line this up here, straight as possible. My template, around my template. And again, I'm going to cut just to the inside, let's start down here, of the line. Now I'm going to check this with lining it up. I just want a very narrow margin. So it looks like I need to trim just a little here. So just have to play with it. Doesn't have to be totally perfect. I'm going to need some trim off from here. I'm happy with that. So I'm going to go ahead and glue this pattern down. Now if you want to ink, go ahead and ink now. I'm going to use a potion, which is kind of a really dark gray, almost black. Just going to ink the edges here. And into the curve. So ink your pattern paper if you want. I'm going to go ahead and glue this on, so make sure you're putting glue to the back side. Make sure you burnish it down good. And then if you need to trim any that you feel you maybe have too much, just go ahead and do that. But I think it looks pretty good. Be careful not to trim away too much. Okay, so now we want the other side. Okay, I'm going to glue it down. Oh, got to ink it. Don't forget to ink. Inking just kind of hits that white where the paper's cut, kind of finishes it off. And if you want a little more onto the front, then you can. I do tend to ink lighter. Some people like to ink a little heavier, and it's perfectly fine, whatever you prefer. So let's glue this on now. I think these are really quick, easy projects that you could do for as a secret Santa gift. With them being made out of paper, you could even hang them on your mantle if you wanted to for decoration. Put this one here. Okay, so there's our front and back of our stocking. Now we're ready to put the accordion piece in. So this is going to be the front and this is the back. So we're going to line this up. We're going to put one side down first. So I'm going to put glue on one entire side. I'm going to really cover it good with glue because this is where you're going to be putting your little gifts and goodies. Take this one here. So we want to line it up at the top, center it side to side, so that it stays within the stocking. Okay, let me double check that. Okay, now burnish it down, flip it over, burnish this side. Now, if you wanted to make this a little bit longer, you could. I just wanted it to stop down here in this part. So, I'm going to put my glue here. Line this up. Try to line up your stockings, too. Now then, here at the toe, I'm just going to lift it up and I'm going to put glue in here so that it makes it one piece down here at the foot. I'm going to glue that down. Because all of your goodies will go inside here. Okay, just like that. So now your stocking is made. See how it looks on the side, the front? Now all you need to do is decorate. So I'm going to do that off camera. I'm going to decorate it and then I'll be back to show you. You can add like a pull, a loop, a ribbon here. Probably use an eyelet to make it stay. Now I have it off just a little bit right here and I'm probably going to trim this out just a tiny bit on this piece, just to make it look a little better. Not too much. There we go. And I'll ink that little bit again, just to keep it in line. So I think that turns out really cute. I'm going to decorate it, and I'll be back to show you what I've done. I have my little paper Christmas stocking decorated, and I wanted to share with you what I did. Before decorating it, the first thing I did was add this braided ribbon on the side. So you could add lace if you want to. Pick this up. headed mustache from one of the larger craft stores. It's a gold metallic braided ribbon, and it does fray quite a bit, so I used glue on the ends. I applied score tape to each half and then wrapped it around the cut edges, the edges of my stocking, all the way around, rounded it around. And then where the split is, then I also put some here in the split and brought it down into this V point right here and used glue to help secure it. So I used that. Then I created the cuff, and I thought that I had done that on camera, but I must have accidentally turned it off. So I took one of the 4x6 cards from the collection. You could just use a scrap of paper, and you want to make sure that you cut it to about 4.5 inches wide, 4 inches the other way. Score the 4-inch in half so that you can fold it, scored at 2 so that you can fold it in half. And then I rounded the corners just on the bottom edge, and then I glued it onto the front or the back. You have 2 of these. You want to cut 2 this size. So one on the front, you would glue it here onto this. Then I folded it over. Actually, before I folded it over, I flattened it out like this. And then I took a pin and I did a dot, pushed this in, did a dot so that I crossed from this opening here. And then I took my scissors and I just cut the slot. Then this tucks into the inside and then glues down. So the slot, or the part of the accordion here, so that you have a piece that fits down in that and then the others on the outside. I hope that makes sense. And you do that on both sides the exact same way. Then I added some of these die cut, glittery snowflake die cuts that I had in my stash. And then I started layering up with flowers. I used the different poinsettias from the Prima collection that goes with this Christmas in the Country. They're getting in short supply on these flowers. I think the company's trying to get more in. Check Country Craft Creations for flowers. These here stems are from the collection, as well as all of these and this one up here. These red here are a stem that I had in my collection that you can pick up at a craft store. Some kind of stemmed flower. And then I used this little gold ribbon that I had in my stash, and I made a bow and attached it here in the corner, and then added another flower. And then to hang my little stocking, I took my crop-a-doll and punched a large hole in the back left section of the accordion. I set a gold eyelet in there, and then I threaded and knotted some of the gold ribbon so that it can hang from a mantle or on the wall. And I think it turned out really cute, so I hope that you will try to make one. You can make several of these and make really cute gifts for swaps, or, you know, to give to people, maybe attached to a package, and you could fill this with candy and stuff. There's plenty of room in here for some small candies, small gifts. Put it in there. You could use it for decoration, and I think it just turned out really cute, so I'm kind of excited with this. It's easy to make, and so I encourage you to try one. Shop for your Christmas paper collections at countrycraftcreations.com. I strictly use the art glitter glue on my project, except for the score tape, which you also can get from Country Craft Creations, for my trim here. So, and thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.